बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया आप सब लोगों का जो यहाँ है। मुझे पता है शहर से ये कितना दूर है और कितनी एफर्ट चाहिए यहाँ आने के लिए, तो आई एम रियली थैंकफुल टू यू ऑल। मैं रिक्वेस्ट करूँगा आप लोग सब आगे हो जाइए, आगे हो जाएं, पीछे पीछे बैठे हैं सारे, आगे काफ़ी जगह खाली है।
मैं करूँ
आसान।
I'll be doing tilawat for Surah Al-Hashr, last three ayah. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو عالم الغيب والشهادة هو الرحمن الرحيم هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار المتكبر سبحان الله عما يشركون هو الله الخالق البارئ المصور له الأسماء الحسنى يسبح له ما في السماوات والأرض وهو العزيز الحكيم. Translation: He is Allah, besides whom there is no God, the knower and the knower of the unseen and the seen. He is the beneficent and the most merciful. He is Allah, besides whom there is no God, the King, the Holy, the Giver of Peace, the Granter of Security, Guardian over all, the Mighty, the Supreme, the Possessor of every greatness. Glory be to Allah from what they set up with Him. He is Allah, the Creator, the Maker, the Fashioner. His are the most excellent names. Whatever is in the heavens and the earth declares His glory, and He is the Mighty, the Wise. Sadaqallahu al-Azim.
जनवरी के अंदर मैंने कोई 30 साल काम करके आई डिसाइडेड कि मैं अपना काम शुरू करूं, और एक कंसल्टेंसी का काम मैंने शुरू किया। और जनवरी में मेरी मुलाकात हुई शाहजहां के साथ, उन्होंने कहा हम एनआईसी बना रहे हैं, तो एनआईसी के अंदर हम कोई चीज़ करते हैं मिलके और उसको हम किसी तरफ लेके जाते हैं। लास्ट मंथ मेरी दोबारा मुलाकात हुई शाहजहां से, और हमने डिसाइड किया कि यहाँ पे एनआईसी के अंदर जो इतनी खूबसूरत बिल्डिंग बनी है इतनी इन्वेस्टमेंट के साथ, तो हम एक ई कॉमर्स एंड लॉजिस्टिक्स सेंटर क्रिएट करते हैं यहाँ पे, जहाँ पे हम ई कॉमर्स और लॉजिस्टिक्स से रिलेटेड जो इंडस्ट्री के प्रोफेशनल्स हैं उनको बुलाएं, जिनकी जिन्होंने काफ़ी काम किया हुआ है, जिनके ने बहुत बड़ी अचीवमेंट्स की हुई हैं उनको बुलाएं, जिनके बहुत एक्सपीरियंस है, और नए जो हमारे स्टार्टअप्स हैं उनको वो नॉलेज दें जो कि बहुत देर से मिलती है। और इसके लिए ये ई कॉमर्स एंड लॉजिस्टिक सेंटर हमने शुरू किया, और हमने याहिया साहब को दावत दी कि वो आएँ और इसको ले कर आगे चलें। मैं अब बुलाऊंगा शाहजहान को कि वो आए और एनआईसी के बारे में हमें थोड़ी सी बात करें इसके ऊपर.
Assalamualaikum Jamil sahab. Assalamualaikum ji. Thank you Jamil sahab. So National Incubation Center जो है हमने सेटअप किया है, लॉन्च हुआ है 11th मई को. हमारा फर्स्ट बैच 1st अगस्त से आ रहा है और ब्रॉडली इट्स मोर ऑफ एन एक्सेलरेटर. वी लुकिंग फॉर कंपनीज जो कि जिनके स्केलिंग अप के चैलेंजेस हैं, जो कि ऑब्स्टिकल्स को हम रिमूव कर सकें, चाहे वो पार्टनरशिप्स डेवलप करनी हो, चाहे वो इन्वेस्टर्स को एक्सेस करना हो, चाहे आपको मेंटर्स चाहिए हो पाकिस्तान से या ग्लोबली. और एक हमारे दोस्त हैं उसामा हाशमी, वो कहते हैं कि द प्रोसेस यू आर फॉलोइंग इज मोर लाइक अ वेंचर बिल्डिंग प्रोसेस देन अ यू नो इनक्यूबेशन प्रोसेस. तो इट्स गोइंग टू बी वेरी कस्टमाइज बेस्ड ऑन ईच कंपनी एंड देयर रिक्वायरमेंट्स एंड नीड्स एंड यू नो देयर एस्पिरेशंस. वी विल लुक एट देम एज पोटेंशियल इन्वेस्टीज जिसके साथ हम मिलकर काम कर रहे हैं टू हेल्प देम ग्रो अप. ई कॉमर्स एंड लॉजिस्टिक सेंटर बनाने की वजह जमील साहब के साथ जो थी वो बहुत सिंपल सी थी कि ई कॉमर्स इज अ कोर एरिया जिसके जरिए जो डिजिटल की जो भी स्पेस है वो मोनेटाइज होती है. और इस स्पेस के अंदर जो है अभी अलीबाबा के इन्वेस्टमेंट के बाद पाकिस्तान में काफ़ी एवोल्यूशन आनी है. तो हमारे जो लोकल प्लेयर्स स्पेशली हैं, चाहे वो मार्केट प्लेसेस हों, चाहे वो पेमेंट्स की स्पेस में हों, चाहे वो लॉजिस्टिक्स की साइड पे हों, सबके लिए अपॉर्चुनिटी भी बहुत बड़ी है और चैलेंजेस भी बहुत बड़े हैं. सो उनको एड्रेस करने के लिए, चाहे वो पाकिस्तान की एक्सपोर्ट्स हों, चाहे वो लोकल मार्केट हो, चाहे हमारी एग्रीकल्चर की वैल्यू चेन हो, हर स्पेस के अंदर हम लोगों को आपस में बात करने की और इंगेज करने की और कनेक्ट करने की ज़रूरत है. फेसबुक हैज़ एग्रीड टू बी आर पार्टनर फॉर द फर्स्ट ईयर इन द ई कॉमर्स एंड लॉजिस्टिक्स सेंटर एंड वी लुकिंग फॉर पार्टनर्स इन द लॉजिस्टिक्स पेमेंट्स एंड मार्केट प्लेस एंड अदर एरियाज. सो वो अभी गोइंग फॉरवर्ड जमील साहब जैसे जैसे आप लोगों से कोऑर्डिनेट करेंगे तो उसके बारे में एक्सप्लोर करेंगे किस तरह से आप लोगों के लिए अपॉर्चुनिटीज़ भी क्रिएट हो सकती हैं और किस तरह से आपके जो भी आप बिल्ड करना चाह रहे हैं उसमें आपकी हेल्प भी हो सकती है. आई विल रिक्वेस्ट मिस्टर याया खान, ही इज द चीफ डिजिटल डिजिटल एंड ब्रांचलेस बैंकिंग ऑफिसर एट बैंक अल्फला टू जॉइन अस ऑन द स्टेज. सो ही इज फेमस फॉर बिल्डिंग अ पीजी पैसा, बट आई थिंक इनका करंट रोल जो है ज्यादा चैलेंजिंग है. लेट्स सी के कैसे चल रहा है.
Depends what side of the divide you look at, but yes, I think this this role is definitely challenging. Assalamu alaikum. So I'm actually humbled to be called by Shahjahan Sahab, Jameel Sahab, to actually come in and speak to the startups and the fintechs, a community which is very close to my heart, and also some of my industry colleagues and peers. I don't consider myself any authority on any of the topics that I'm going to speak about, but I'll try and do my best. and I also think, this facility, which is, I think, a perfect example of a fantastic collaboration of industry and the government to come together, is beautiful. I think to actually look at the facilities which are being provided here, even coming from industry, I think this is the best state-of-the-art facility that I've actually ever seen, certainly in Pakistan. So great work. I thought I would start off with setting the scene a little bit, and the topic, as Shahjahan Sahab and Jameel Sahab mentioned, we thought what we think is relevant to actually promoting the game of logistics and e-commerce in Pakistan. And certainly one topic that I might be a little bit familiar about is the space of payments and thereof credit, and the role of payments and credit in boosting the e-commerce in the country. Is it here? So if you look at the market in Pakistan, I think it was projected that we'll probably hit the $1 billion sales of e-commerce in 2020. It probably has happened a few years sooner than that, there are comparison stats here, and you can slice and dice and skin the cat however you like. But I think the encouraging part out of these numbers are the growth that we have seen in Pakistan. And I'm not going to lose my sleep anytime soon with the growth that I look in India. Fine, I think they've had a head start, and you know, long may it continue, but we are certainly getting there. We are catching up. Our freelance community is actually one of the most sought after communities also of Pakistan. The other encouraging stat out of these stats is the number of connected users between small screen and large screen. Jo ke 50 million hamare subscribers hain between 3G, 4G and fiber to home ke upar jo connect hue hain. That I think is a fantastic achievement, which I think telcos have a lot of credit to take in the country. Now it's incumbent upon the rest of the marketplace players, such as the logistics company, the e-commerce companies, the banks, the payment service providers, to actually take advantage of the ecosystem that has been created. So if anything, if you want to take away from this slide, is two key facts. One is that the growth of e-commerce that we have seen is actually has surpassed the expectations that we had. And number two, the number of connected users in this country is actually close to half the adult population of Pakistan, which I think are the two key parameters and for the ecosystem development here. I think some of the challenges, you know, a few of you might be more familiar with those challenges, and I see some familiar faces who have actually done it all and seen it all, is the cash on delivery. We have talked about it for a long time. They can cash on delivery. Even when, you know, we started Easy Paisa, it's very hard to beat something that actually works. If something isn't broken, nobody wants to change it. You know, we talk for England about OTC ko kis tarah se replace kare with mobile account, but OTC was working. It was working. So you would not change something that's not. So isi tarike se cash on delivery works. With as much as an e-commerce merchant might hate, and as much as a bank might like to replace cash on delivery with a prepayment, but it works. It has an embedded escrow service in it. That's the reason why perhaps nobody ever thought about a good escrow service in our country also. Because for consumer, this is the best consumer protection. I can change my mind right up to the last minute. Right? We were talking Jameel Saab Sipar earlier. There's a lot of cost involved in the returns also. But then, you know, this is the customer's choice. He wishes to do that. We can only replace something if we replace it with something which is, if not better, at least at par. And it takes some inefficiencies from the supply chain. Then on e-commerce, I think the market is still relatively raw. We are nowhere near some of those things which are listed here. I don't think the market is even there to look at them as even challenges. The concept of pop-up stores, right? The concept of drone deliveries, I don't think we're even there yet. The good thing out of this is e-commerce is providing opportunities to established or unestablished vendors or merchants to be able to sell their goods or services. The rest of us are just supporting cast in it, right? And we'll try and do our best. I thought let's start off with the Alibaba example a little bit, and I don't like deliberately to use other countries' examples, but at the same time we have to look at some of the success stories. Right? Why recreate the wheel if the wheel has already been created somewhere? So Alibaba started obviously much before Alipay, the company that bought my previous organization, was started. And when I at least started interacting with them, it was very clear their thought process. And their thought process was, is, and will remain, okay, we want to be the world's largest, and they already are, the e-commerce marketplace. And we would do anything and everything to support that e-commerce marketplace. So I repeat, the objective is to remain the e-commerce marketplace. They at one point in time were the biggest SME bank of China. The exposure that they had between the merchant financing and consumer financing made them the largest SME bank of China. And then they became so successful, and I'll try and connect the dots in a second. And then they became so successful in actually the data they were getting through the payments that they started to monetize that data. And they started to sell that data. And there were banks who were queuing up to actually buy that data on which they would have developed their credit scorecard and done financing, both for consumers and merchants. So when they entered in Pakistan, a few might actually have been part of their due diligence. They scanned the country for everything that was available. They were after a payments company, a wallet provider, which they found in EasyPesa. They were after a logistics company, and there are talks about, and they are after a marketplace provider or an e-commerce provider. And they always try and join all these three things together. They like to control, and I agree with that. They like to control all of these three aspects. Acha, now let's just start to join the dots a little bit. So we all talk about contextual marketing. We all talk about offering something to the consumer at the right place, at the right time, at the right price. We all talk about that. I think we have gone beyond the age of scattergun marketing. People have started to realize the conventional ATLs and BTLs do not work. The first evolution was to go on digital. Even digital ke upar sabse pehle companies ne normal standard scattergun digital marketing shuru ki, because then it was a cost game. TV costs a lot of money, let's move to digital, still do scattergun. Okay, it's an evolution. Then GDN marketing karo, Facebook marketing karo, market to the consumer's Facebook page, who I think is the right consumer, is the next evolution of it. Fine. And then the third evolution is to actually, do I know with the live current information of my consumers, the every minute of the day, where is he spending that minute? Doesn't matter whether he's online or offline. That's the obsession with data. That's the obsession of data that actually lands organizations such as Facebook in hot water sometimes. Right? But that's that obsession. So that, why? So that I can actually offer the contextually correct product or service or price. So with Ali, sticking to Alibaba's example, if I have the marketplace, I would like to digitize the payments, and it's not to eliminate cash on delivery. I think we got our enemy wrong. We wanted to eliminate cash on delivery, but if we could have thought that we want digital payments so that we can collect the data for the merchant and the consumer, so that we can do consumer and merchant financing. That's the gibberish that I'm going to talk about for the next 15-20 minutes. That's what it is. And that's exactly what other successful organizations in the world have done. There's no rocket science. The rocket science is not in the strategy. The rocket science is in the execution of that strategy. How can we successfully incentivize a consumer, which is called the acquisition cost for us, to actually start making digital payments? Because the merchant is forever ready. You go to a merchant and you talk to them, and they'll say, yeah, it takes your 2-2.5% return, logistics, cash on delivery costs. They'll say, I'm ready. But the consumers are not ready. So the organizations have to be prepared to offer something that works for them and also be prepared to have a customer acquisition cost. And then if the consumer moves to doing digital payments, and by the way, for those of you who know me for a very long time, I've been talking about it, and it's heartening to now see that other organizations have started to a little bit believe in it also. I don't think the MDR game is going to last for any given period of time, the merchant discount rate game. Abhi toh the online payment gateways come to a merchant and they say, dekho 2% toh tum cash on delivery par bhi de rahe the na, 2% hume bhi de do, then it's an even game. But why should a merchant just replace a cost like for like? The merchant, the success comes when we eliminate the cost from the supply chain and replace the profitability with something else that also works. So agar maine ek merchant ki 2% cost nikal ke cash on delivery usko replace kar diya with a 2% MDR, what a big deal. The supply chain costs remain in supply chain. It's just that instead of a logistics company making that 2% margin, now the bank is making the 2% MDR margin. So what? However, if I had said that I am actually going to not charge an MDR, so take that cost out of supply chain, and I am going to make the money out of the float income from the merchant account and the consumer account and the merchant financing income that I'm going to do and the consumer financing income that I'm going to do, that's when you increase the pie, grow the business both for e-commerce merchant as well as the customer, and also make money as a significant player in the supply chain. Nobody says not to make money. If the banks are here, the payment service providers are here, they have to make money out of it, otherwise it's not a sustainable model. So the last piece of string here is, and I feel that this is where the role of banks is. The role of banks is not to charge an MDR. Achha, chale, let's spend a little bit of time, because I see some fresh faces also. Maybe I'm assuming a lot more knowledge than I should. But you know, if you look at a conventional bank, I actually feel, and I say this thing, and you know, my own mancom hates me for saying this thing, but you know, we have to. I think most banks have already lost it. It's not that they're going to lose it, they've lost it. And they've lost it to fintechs and startups, and in some cases to telcos. For example, imagine a situation, and it's actually happening, or if not happened, as you're going to see very soon in Pakistan also, inshallah. A consumer goes on an e-commerce web store. They buy, say, a fridge. They get offered financing on that fridge on a real-time basis. This customer is not a credit card customer of any bank. I'm talking about a brand new virgin customer who goes, selects an item. He gets given an offer ki aap cash pe le le ya installment pe le le. And he chooses to take on installment, and the fridge gets delivered. In all of this value chain, he never gets to see beyond that e-commerce website. For all intensive purposes, he is and remains the customer of that e-commerce startup. Many of you might have been sitting in this room. Uske piche ek bulge bracket bank hoega shayad, such as mine maybe, thinking, oh, we have just done a consumer financing, look at my ENR and net receivable, look, my balance sheet is growing. Great stuff. We are making some spreads. We are making some spreads, but the customer was never mine. Customer actually never even got to see the name of my bank. Do we take questions, Jamil sahab, now, or should we wait till the end of this talk? Theek, if you can hold it. So so the so one is that example. I remember, and again I'm only quoting this example for ease of people to understand and grasp. I think it was 4 years ago, I attended a GSMA conference in Barcelona, and there was a live session between Mark Zuckerberg of Facebook and this global CEO of Telenor at the time, Frederick Beksas. And in that live chat, which we were all attending, Zuckerberg said to Beksas that I think you guys or telcos are going to be reduced to dumb pipes in a few years. You would actually not own the number of customers that you claim you own. And it was a good public speech. Everybody enjoyed this conversation. And look, while obviously telcos woke up since that day, the challenge, and they started to all have chief digital officers and launch their own digital initiatives, for them to soon realize that, you know, there can only be one Facebooks and one WhatsApps and one Airbnbs, and, you know, in order for you to cut through the thousands of other startups and fintech failures, you have to be nimble enough. You know, Facebook and all of these big successful startup companies were started in the bedrooms or garages. Big companies, by the time they've become big, have already lost it. So actually starting a digital division in that thinking, I'm going to launch the next app which is going to compete with Facebook, was actually a bit naive, but anyway, it was the strategy at the time. So the message for as many as fintechs and startups are here is that I think the train is with you guys right now. The train is not with the big organizations. Big organizations are trying to fit in. PSD2 in Europe, how many of you have heard of? Payment systems regulation. Yeah, at least one person. I'm great to hear. In Europe, the regulation has already come, which has mandated the banks to open their APIs to any fintech or startup should they come to them. Think. So if you are a fintech or a startup and you make a nice glossy app for payments and other banking services, and you can make it much better than any bank can, right? And then all you need is the API access to the stored value accounts which this bank was holding for the last 70 years, and you say open it now because you are mandated to open it, and the customer is going to use my app to do all the functions. So whose customer you think this customer is? That fintech startup who no one had heard of, or the bulge bracket investment bank or retail bank? Is that fintech startup, and it's regulated. I think it's a matter of time this thing is going to come to Pakistan. Regulator is already aware of it in Pakistan also. So hence I say, so I qualify my statement when I say okay, the train is at your stop right now. But bigger organizations trying to fit in. So let's look at another example. Acha, with having done all that that I encapsulated, obviously at a super excellent way that Alibaba does, and having formed Alipay, they created $500 billion company. Yeah, that's it. That's not it. I'm sure they spent a lot more time and blood and sweat into it. Paytm in India started off as, a few of you are telco colleagues, started off as a VAS service, value added service, selling airtime for telcos, like one load in Pakistan, for those of you who are familiar. That's it. That's all they were doing. And then they thought, let's set up our own e-commerce marketplace. But before that, my apologies, before that, they already were relatively successful in wallets. Just like some of the local organizations we have here, one of them, as I said before, that Ant Financial bought, right? So they were already successful in wallets. That's why is the obsession with wallets. Wallets is a stored value account which a customer has, which means that the customer has the means to pay. So a digital wallet means if I have a flush digital wallet, I have means to pay. If I have means to pay, you can sell me anything. That's what we learned in EasyPesa for over 4.5 years while I was there. As long as the person has a stored value account, a digital stored value account, he'll buy. So our effort was actually not on selling. Our effort was actually having people to keep money in their account. That's why we all started back then. 2000 rupees rakho to 50 minute every day free power. It was not my obsession to give 50 minutes free, because we knew if you had the money in your account, we can sell things. So that's the obsession with wallets. So Paytm started to have these wallets which people were using to buy airtime. And back then in India, just like up until a few, actually a couple of years ago in Pakistan also, we did not have any credible wallet from where people can buy airtime. It's ironic. Because this product of airtime had such a pull, us telcos, or at least while I was there, we were sitting pretty. As long as the pull is there, 75 million people of this country would actually walk to one of my 250,000 stores to buy airtime. That's how we have operated for as many years. Abhi bhi, maybe for those of you who are prepaid customers of any telco, haath uthaye, kafi hone chahiye, right? Aur kitne log aap log online khareedte hain airtime aur kitne dukaan pe jaake khareedte hain? Ye online wale ya dukaan wale? Ye online hai. Dukaan pe kitne log jaake khareedte hain? Half and half. Even in this room of fintech startups, आधे लोग हमारे इस कमरे में भी जाके दुकानों पे जाते हैं और एयर टाइम खरीदते हैं. आयरोनिक. सो सेम सिचुएशन वॉज इन इंडिया, नो डिफरेंट. ये तो वैसे यू नो ऑन अ सीरियस नोट, ये अल्लाह भला करे ऑफ एप्स सच एज बैंक्स हु स्टार्टेड टू सेल कंसोलिडेटेड एयर टाइम्स बाय कनेक्टिंग विद वन लिंक. तो जो हाफ ऑफ यू हु सेड ऑनलाइन ना, एटलीस्ट यू हैव योर बैंक्स टू थैंक कि उधर से जाके खरीद लेते हैं. एनीवे, so Paytm had wallets. When they had wallets, that's where I think 80% of the game was won, if you had stored value accounts. And then they thought, you know what, let's just also launch, nice to have, an e-commerce marketplace. And it's not that nice to have, there are reasons for that. And the reasons for having an e-commerce marketplace, if you have your own stored value account, is very different than a conventional e-commerce player. A conventional e-commerce player thinks of making a margin on a product he sells. That's it. Fridge mein 20,000 ka khareedunga, 25,000 ka bech dunga, 5,000 ka mera profit hai, and meri supply chain cost ko minimum rakhunga, main overheads ko minimum rakhunga because I'm an e-commerce store. That's what my business is about. And yes, uske baad kuch science aa chuki hai thodi si, ki how can I make contextual marketing, how can I attract my customers to come to me and all that. All great, but the bottom line still is, it's a margin game on per product basis. That's how an e-commerce merchant, in my humble opinion, likes to think. A bank, however, or a marketplace, however, or organizations such as Paytm, however, would think slightly differently. They are not that interested in just making a product margin. They are interested in getting the customer data, the eyeball, the amount of time he browsed, the number of products he looked at, and then ultimately what made him make the decision that he did in the end. Because today, we don't get to see all of the above as banks. We only get to see the end payment that happened. So I don't know इस पेयर ऑफ लेदर शूज को खरीदने से पहले उसने कितनी और चीजों को देखा, कितनी चीजों को आईबॉल मूवमेंट की उसने, कितनी चीजों के ऊपर वो ठहरा, कितनी चीजों के ऊपर ही डिडंट हैव इनफ मनी टू बाय, एंड देन अल्टीमेटली ही सेटल्ड ऑन समथिंग व्हिच वाज इक्वलेंट टू द मनी दैट ही हैड इन हिज वॉलेट. What if I knew all of this information and I offered him credit at that point in time? Okay, I think you've spent more than 30 seconds of eyeball on this product and I know you don't have enough money in your wallet right now. Here is a credit for you. Buy it. So a bank or any other organization other than an e-commerce player would look at the e-commerce marketplace very differently. Then sometimes the bank would actually sell a product at a loss. An e-commerce merchant would never do that. They'll do it to attract some acquisition, agar spree chal rahi hai aapki to. But otherwise, they would not, because their business model is skewed then. Why would they sell something at a loss? A financial services organization such as Alipay, Paytm, I call them, they've got an e-money license, may be able to sell a product at a loss because they have other means to make money, which is through float income, which is in a wallet of consumer and merchant, and financing for consumers and merchants. It's a very different way of looking at the same coin. Consumer wins in all these cases, yeah, which is great actually to hear. So same, the message that I wanted to leave with these two slides, and I don't want to talk for too long. I want to pause having shared some of these thoughts. I want to have an interactive session, as interactive as I hope it could be. But very similar case studies is the message that I wanted to leave with, both in the cases of Alibaba, Alipay and Paytm. Both, their starting points were different. Alibaba started as an e-commerce company and then came into the wallets game, then came into merchant and consumer financing, became the largest SME bank of China, right? But controlled the whole ecosystem in the end. Paytm's starting point was they were already a VAS company, not an e-commerce company, a VAS company selling airtimes. They already had wallets. So in a way, they already had Alipay before they set up Alibaba. Then they set up Alibaba in the case of Paytm I'm talking about, right? But ultimately they both realize the power of stored value account doesn't matter where you start from. Alibaba also today thinks they make more money through monetization of data, merchant and consumer financing, ab itni nahi karte merchant financing, but through the monetization of data, then actually the spreads in selling the products on e-commerce. Right. Lastly, I think I just want to leave with this slide. This is, I'm going to generalize this. I think the role of a good payment gateway is to have, and this is an aspiration of mine, whether I'll be able to see it through inshallah in my lifespan, time would tell, but to actually have a merchant in a box like a PayPal. Why do we banks, and I have done it also, have to take a 12 pager form for a payment gateway and a bank account opening to an e-commerce merchant? Who would know better than Uzair sitting here, right? Why do we have to do this thing? He's an e-commerce merchant, for Christ's sake, at the end of the day. Yeah? So anyway, I think the payment gateways of tomorrow who are actually going to survive are the ones who offer the experience of download this SDK, install this gateway on your website, open a merchant account, be up and running for accepting payments, and once you've accepted payments for whatever, say 1, 2, 3 months, I'm offering you a standard merchant financing line. and I have got a built-in escrow service for those merchants who wish to take. And guess what? Do three, four merchants ne agar ek achhi built-in escrow service le li, then consumer pressure would be so much on the rest of the merchants that they would all have to take it also. And then yes, the means to pay could be any. Credit debit card is waqt chalte hain, credit cards predominantly, wo bhi jis ke chalte hain. Aksar ke to CROs ne band kiye hain, chief risk officers ne. So, but then there could be other ways of paying, direct through app, there could be a tokenizations or whatever. So, so I'm going to stop and then I'll take questions and hopefully give some answers. But I want to leave on a small story. And again, for those of you who know me, I love this, and with apologies because I love this story, so I'm repeating it. Ek bachcha sahil samandar pe khada hota hai, aur wo ek high tide aati hai, aur bahut sari starfish jo hai wo seashore pe aa jati hai. And he started to pick them, those starfish, one by one, and started to throw them back into the sea. Or there was a grown-up man who was walking by. He looked at this kid for some time in amazement, and then he walked up to this kid and said, "Buddy, this is not going to make any difference what you're doing. There are millions of starfish on the seashore, so it's not going to make any difference with the actions." The kid picked up yet another starfish, looked at it, threw it back in the sea, and said, "Hell yeah, it is going to make the most difference in the life of this particular starfish." So, for all of us who are connected with this industry, whether it's e-commerce, whether it's logistics, whether it's payments, whether it's banking services, whether it's financial inclusion, something I know a few of us feel very dearly about, it's actually not whether this whole ecosystem and the things that I just talked about are so far-fetched and Alibaba has done it and Paytm has done it and we would never be able to do it. We don't think like that, and you mustn't either, for those youngsters, startups and fintechs who are listening. Let's just see what difference does it actually make to one single life. And if we can really, coming back to business, if we can really, my vision is, if we can really enable a Facebook merchant who was selling cakes, a female selling cakes on Facebook but does not have enough money to expand her business. If I can digitize the payments for her, give her merchant in a box, offer her merchant financing, I think we've made the difference in that one person's life. Thank you. You know, open for questions.
I just want थोड़ा सा volume to fix. मैं ये पूछना चाह रहा था.
So the mode of payment was digital in that example. Yeah. And jo maine puri science uske piche nahi batai, wo science ye hai ke obviously banks need to know that particular customer, and how they would have known that particular customer is two ways, different ways of the same way of data acquisition as Facebook now, through the consent and permission of customers acquire that data. The spending attitude, whether in-app cookies ke zariye, whether their browsing history, whether their social media history ke zariye, organizations create a credit scorecard. on that customer. And then in the database of the organization, against a particular customer, they have a credit scoring available. कि इस कस्टमर को मैं इतने हजार रुपए तक की क्रेडिट दे सकता हूं एट वॉट एवर टाइम ही और शी डिमांड्स एंड दैट्स हाउ दे ऑफर द क्रेडिट एट दैट पॉइंट टाइम बट फॉर दैट टू हैपन दे नीड टू हैव दैट डेटा थ्रू मल्टीपल सोर्सेज ऑफ एग्रीगेशन इट्स ऑलरेडी हैपनिंग इन पाकिस्तान देयर लॉट्स ऑफ कंपनीज वर डूइंग इट Yeah, Nadeem did that through Tez Financial, for those of you who know that. Easy Paisa did that about a year ago, jab humne consumer credit launch kiya tha. Similar loans up to 10,000 rupees ke upar. And again, we had a credit, digital credit scorecard, no human touch. We didn't even want to meet the customer because we wanted to take the credit administration cost out of the whole supply chain. So it was all done through digital scoring. Knowing your spending patterns, knowing your browsing patterns, knowing how much airtime you buy, knowing which bank you bank with and the number of SMSs you receive from those bank, through your consent, reading those SMSs, right? And then creating a browsing data and a browsing history, a credit history of that person. Ek mazedar misal deta hun, then I'll move to the second question. I think about 3 years ago, when I was still in Easy Paisa, मुझे किसी ने मुबारकबाद का मैसेज भेजा मुबारक हो आप लोगों ने डिजिटल कंज्यूमर लोन्स लॉन्च कर दी मैं खुद बड़ा हैरान हुआ मैं मुबारकबाद तो ग्रेसफुली एक्सेप्ट कर ली उसके बाद मैंने अपनी टीम से पूछा भाई ये कब हुआ हमने डिजिटल कंज्यूमर लोन्स लॉन्च कर दिए उन्होंने कहा नहीं हमने तो नहीं किए लॉन्च सो देर वॉज अ फिनटेक और अ स्टार्टअप who was using, unfortunately, that's the only mistake, rookie mistake he did. He was using the name of Easy Paisa, right? And he called it Easy Paisa Loans. And he put it on Play Store, Google ke. And what that app was doing, actually, You download it used to ask all the permissions ki aap permission dete hain sms ki iski photos ki camera use ki everybody says yes 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 in all cases and that's when the apk was used to be installed within the app wo phir in app cookies ke zariye aapki sari activity ko lock karta tha which is what most other credit scoring apps do these days aur usko and the genius of that thing was he used to I'll put it here acha okay what the genius of all this was he actually used to the app used to read the smss from easy paisa in his inbox from 3737 jo hamara short code hota tha And based on the reading of those SMSs only, he created a credit profiling of the consumer and set it up as a non-banking financial institute, NBFI आप बन सकते हैं और यार मुझे दूसरा दे दें अगर हैंड माइक है चले I'll try and hold it like this and he started offering loans. There was nothing illegal in any of this he did. The only rookie mistake he made, as I said, was he started using the name of Easy Paisa.
Yeah. Anyway, any other question? No, it's not. If you set up an NBFI, you don't have to be registered with State Bank of Pakistan for giving credit. So he set it up as an NBFI. Anyone can 10,000 rupees ke andar NBFI ban jaye aur loans dene lag jaye. That's okay because it's your own capital at risk. Nobody cares when you're putting your own capital at risk.
Okay, the question is that if a person does not already exist on social media, how are you going to do a credit, digital credit profiling of that customer to give the loans? Achha, iske do teen answers hain. Ek to ye ki you'll be surprised, some digital credit companies, including some banks, actively seek out bad customers because they need to train their model with who not to loan out to when they commercially launch big scale. So shuru mein to, and we did a similar thing in my previous organization, shuru mein to you actually actively seek out the customer, and we encourage the product managers not to do any credit profiling so that you can then use advanced analytics afterwards to weed out, and you say these are the kinds of customer I don't want to give out to. But in order to train your model, you do. So first answer is that where we are in Pakistan is, I think most organizations are seeking out a uniformity of customers. Second is social media is no, in fact social media is waqt limited istemal ho raha hai Pakistan mein, limited bahar zyada ho raha hai for credit scoring. Pakistan mein zyada credit scoring ho rahi hai is waqt wo do basis pe ho rahi hai. One is your in app cookies monitoring, जो आपकी ब्राउजिंग, आपकी हर एक्टिविटी, आपकी एसएमएस से सबको रीड करती है, एंड यू एक्सप्लिसिटली परमिटेड कस्टमर कंसेंट तकरीबन सारी ऐप सब लेती हैं. एंड दूसरी है टेलको के डेटा को यूज़ करते हुए, फॉर एंड टेलको डज नॉट मोनेटाइज और सेल देयर डेटा. सो जो टेलको रिलेटेड फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूट्स हैं उनके पास वो ब्राउजिंग डेटा एंड रिचार्ज डेटा and cell site coverage, aap ek cell site se dusre site par gaye, your friends and family callers numbers, and then they profile based on who you are calling, who you are receiving, you are taking, what packages you are taking, uski basis pe profiling hoti hai, and it's relatively decent profiling. Dekhen, digital credit scorecard, however you cut it, is actually going to be to have a default rate of between 10 to 15%. 10 to 15%, and for those of you who are bankers, it's a suicide to say this number in any boardroom of a bank ki main delinquency 10 to 15% karunga. Banks go under at 5-6% delinquency, they go under, right? But there's a big but, they go under because your total cost of credit underwriting is 20%, which includes about 10-12% your cost of credit administration, which means loan officer jaye, credit information bureau to hai nahi na hamare, nahi, I'm sorry, we have a credit information bureau, but that's a positive credit information bureau which only tells me if you have defaulted on a loan or not, but it doesn't tell me like Experian in the West, it doesn't tell me how much is Mr. X worth, it doesn't tell me that. तो उसको एक्स वर्थ को करने के लिए, एंड बिकॉज रिलेटिव लो पेनिट्रेशन ऑफ बैंकिंग, यू डोंट हैव डिजिटल डेटा, सो यू हैव टू सेंड लोन ऑफिसर, रिलेशनशिप मैनेजर, कागज़ भरवाते हैं, कैश फ्लो स्टेटमेंट भरते हैं, उसके बाद जाके हम एक लोन. तो इस सारे प्रोसेस की क्रेडिट अंडर राइटिंग कॉस्ट इज अबाउट 10 to 12%. विद डिजिटल स्कोर कार्ड यू टेक देयर आउट, एंड येस इनिशियली यू रिप्लेस इट अ लिटल बिट अंडर with a delinquency ratio, but then so what, agar mera net spread, net interest income mera sahi rehta hai, 3-5% ke kareeb rehta hai, who cares? But the unfortunate part is the boardroom mein people still care, it's like a taboo ki yaar aapka delinquency ratio is anywhere above or north of 5-6%. But I think what I want to socialize with you guys at, or at least we are talking about digital credit, is that by any stretch of imagination, digital credit ka ki delinquency is going to be between 10 to 15%, and we should socialize this idea. At least I have in my board. Acha, aur koi question? Yeah.
Going back to the point you mentioned that is there any Alibaba board to take advantage of your bank getting a merchant and getting that logistics
and wallets?
You also mentioned that the thing is with the new tech rather than the company. Coming back to the point that Alibaba does that, to get that triangle within their pocket so that when there are big transactions which are digital transactions, consumer is not hesitant. Because that triangle is within one entity itself. Due to which, if any mishap or any fraud happens, that can be taken care of by the single entity.
Yeah.
And if we compare a loop where the logistics partner is someone else, the merchant is someone else, and the bank is another bank.
Yep.
There is that gap over where the consumer has to hesitant to go for a business transaction.
Yep. No, I agree. I think that's a good correlation that you have made. Agreed. I think with the correlation that we are all fighting with consumer trust right now. And I said consumer trust is on cash on delivery, as I said at the start. And as you said, if I am controlling all three key pillars of the supply chain of e-commerce, which is the e-commerce marketplace, the stored value account, which is the wallets and the logistics company, then I can eliminate a lot more out of this supply chain. And yes, this would also elicit that customer trust, that customers would be a lot more comfortable paying that. Then I can also launch my own escrow service. Then if I become Amazon, then I can rate, or at least consumers can, but I can control the merchants the way I wish to. Remember what I said earlier. I feel, and maybe not a lot of e-commerce merchants may agree with me, but I still feel if financial services providers have to be serious in the game of data, and based on the data do consumer and merchant financing, they cannot just be a subservient to an e-commerce company. They must consider being Amazon, which does financing and marketplace both. Ji, sure. So iske two good question. The question is, if Alibaba is Alibaba and Alibaba continues to become Alibaba, then where's the place for the startups and fintechs? Fair question. Two things. Remember, Alibaba was once a startup itself. Right? Number two, whether it's visible or not to a naked eye, but Alibaba buys lots of companies on a monthly basis. Lots of startups and fintechs on monthly basis. Some badi ho jati hain, like Easy Paisa's transaction we get to know, like Paytm transactions we get to know, but they continue to buy. So the aspiration for a fintech or a startup, actually this reminds me of another good. And I hope that this realization and socialization is a lot more there, because I'm not an e-commerce merchant, right? But for those of you who are, the game, even if you go to, I think most e-commerce websites are either breaking even or loss making, because everybody is in a search of customer acquisition right now. And they're in search of customer acquisition because the play is the exit multiples that I'm going to get if I have X million customers with me. That's the play. It's not a bottom line profit play. So if for a young startup listening to this, I think for you also, the play should be the maximum number of shoppers that I could attract and the valuation I could get if I'm lucky enough to have somebody like Alibaba or somebody buy me, or Rocket Internet, somebody buys me, as opposed to me getting concerned of my bottom line profitability, which, trust me, ain't gonna come, you'll perish. Ek aur question tha piche se. थोड़ा सा जोर से. राइट.
Yeah, so if I summarize, the question is what advice it is for a Facebook merchant, whether they should remain on Facebook or should have their own website. I would never promote anyone to change something if it's working. And if Facebook web front end is working for that lady, then it is working. The role of the rest of the players is to enable her where she is right now. And yes, so when I talked about the merchant in a box concept, that concept was ki wo apne web Facebook store pe, she can download the APK file, she can open a merchant account. Agar abhi easy paisa karwati hain wo logon se ki mujhe easy paisa kar dena, main tumhe maal bhej deti hun, kal ko she would have her own bank account where monies can come directly to her. She can also choose which delivery company I wish to choose, what are the per mile rates of these delivery companies, OCS ki, TCS ki, jo bhi hai. So that in a space of 15 minutes, 20 minutes, half an hour, she can be up and running from an offline, it's ironic, she's on Facebook but an offline merchant, but for all intensive purposes I mean ki uski payments jo thi, wo offline payments thi. So within a space of half an hour, she can have her own bank account. She can get people to start paying using their debit or credit card rather than walking to an Easy Paisa shop and then do it. And then she can also choose the right logistics partner. So that's what I meant by having a merchant in a box.
Yeah. Trying to judge and try to change the behavior of a customer. But if you look at the whole ecosystem, the postal services, the logistic companies, the payment gateways, the banks, and all the players that are involved, the merchants, they have not yet been to a stage where they can believe in e-commerce. So that's why OTC is still very much believable. So I come from a company that basically provides consultancy to USPS and its co-mingler and consolidators. And what we see over there is that USPS, United States Postal Services, on a routine basis, beats the TCSs and the FedExes and the UPSs of this world in parcel delivery. And they co-mingle with them as well, and they co-pilotize with them as well. So do you think that it's been inorganic? It's not starting from where it should, that the whole e-commerce game, and we're just trying to change the consumer behavior rather than, you know, because there was one reason why people went online in the beginning, was that because of the price differentiation. And in Pakistan, people still believe that OTC is the better way to go. You know, I'd rather go to Zenab or, you know, Khata Market or places like that rather than, you know, having a look and feel of the thing that I'm buying rather than, you know, ordering something online.
Yeah. So I agree. I mean, the question, I think, if I summarize, is whether the rest of the players in the ecosystem have really contributed, so that whether I consider the growth of e-commerce in Pakistan has been as accelerated as I claimed on the first slide. So iska do answer hai. Ek to ye ki I think the most, so I agree with you on certainly one point, that the growth of e-commerce was largely left on either the e-commerce merchant himself, or at best, Allah bhala kare, jab ye Black Friday wali campaigns aana shuru hui, to companies like banks and Easy Paisas and Jazz Cashes ne unpe discounts dena shuru kiya. So it was largely left at these two. I think logistics mein nahi kaam hua zyada, with all the humbleness. And logistics is another science, and I'm sure Jamil Saab would tell that the deliveries that Amazon is actually using, that minute of the day on which the delivery is going to come, the special padlocks which get opened through an Amazon pin which people put on their front doors, that the delivery guy can put in and enter, wo Amazon ka lock hota hai. Amazon has started selling those padlocks. वो उस डिलीवरी टाइम के स्लॉट पे वो पिन जनरेट होती है, और सिर्फ उस हाफ एन आवर के लिए जनरेट होती है. वो पोस्टमैन डालता है, दरवाज़ा खुलता है, डिलीवरी रखता है, बाहर आ जाए. वी हैव डन नन ऑफ दैट. इन फैक्ट द लार्ज पार्ट ऑफ पाकिस्तान एरियाज आर स्टिल अनकवर्ड बाय कोरियर. सो अवर ई कॉमर्स इज एज गुड एज द कैपेसिटी ऑफ द डिलीवरी कंपनी, अनफॉर्चुनेटली. एंड द गवर्नमेंट पोस्टल, अच्छा दे बोथ कंबाइन. गवर्नमेंट पोस्टल से we all know, unfortunately, but you'll be surprised. I spent some time understanding Pakistan Post. Pakistan Post ke paas one of the world's oldest cash on delivery service maujood hai. Ye 60 saal se cash on delivery kar rahe hain, but is world's best kept secret. Batana nahi hai kisi ko. Oh, by, or, and when I looked at that transaction, I spent some time at the post offices and GPOs. It's a fantastic product. Karna kya hota hai, merchant ko apne nearest post office pe jaye, jo bhi delivery aapne karani hai na, wo aap delivery ka courier ka saman utha kar jaye, post office ko dein, unki ek fees hai, wo aapse wo collect karte hain, aur aapke ghar pe, I can't remember now the time, 14 days ke andar uska cash aa jata. It exists today. But obviously it's not at a scale where it should have been. As you rightly said, the US Postal Services are far ahead in what. So I think, yes, all of these, I agree with you, all of these ecosystem players have to come together. So either one formidable player does it, which unfortunately we needed Chinese to come and tell us, unfortunately, or we do it. Just one thing. Jee. You're on. वो मेरे मार्केटियर ने बना दी थी ना, इसलिए मैंने जनरलाइज कर दिया.
अगर मैंने फूड पार्टा के ऊपर एक 350 रुपये का मर्डर खरीदा और मैं उन 50 मिलियन ऑनलाइन लोगों में जुड़ा पाकिस्तान, व्हाट पेमेंट ऑप्शन जो आए हैं, क्रेडिट कार्ड कितने लोगों के पास है जो ऑनलाइन चलता है, अल्फला इजी पैसा या जो भी साइलोज हैं, उनमें से मैं किसका मेम्बर हूँ, मैं बैंक अकाउंट का मेम्बर हो सकता हूँ, बैंक अकाउंट होल्डर हो, लेकिन उसके ट्रांजेक्शन चार्जेस जो हैं वो बहुत ज़्यादा. What can the financial industry do, or what should the financial industry do to create a scale where online payments between one bank account and the other is easy and at a very low cost? एक चीज मुझे बड़ी अजीब लगती है पूरे कि मैंने एक बैंक से एटीएम यूज करना है, एटीएम कार्ड यूज करना है किसी दूसरे बैंक के ऊपर, उससे शायद 15 रुपए का, जिसके अंदर बैंक को जो एटीएम प्रोवाइड कर रहा है उसको मशीन भी खरीदनी है, उसको कैश भी उसमें रखना है, सिक्योरिटी भी और उसका आई डी लगाना है तो। लेकिन अगर मैं ऑनलाइन ट्रांजेक्शन कर रहा हूँ बिटवीन माई ऑनलाइन अकाउंट एंड अदर ऑनलाइन अकाउंट, तो वो 50-60 रुपये और I believe these are the things which are actually working in the other direction to discourage digital payments.
Fair enough. I agree. I don't think I have any defense. And I think as an industry, we are responsible for creating this mess. And आपको वो वक्त भी याद होएगा कि जब आप एक ATM मशीन में सिर्फ उसी बैंक का कार्ड चलता था, वो वक्त भी याद होगा जब एक POS मशीन पे सिर्फ उसी की POS उसका कार्ड चलता था, एंड देन द इंडस्ट्री लर्नड ग्रेजुअली। फिर टेलकोज ने भी नहीं सीखा, एक ही जगह पे चार चार टावर्स लगे होते हैं। This unfortunate, the monopolistic thought process that we all have is counterproductive. Then your question is, what is happening? I think the green shoots are now, these bigger organizations have realized that the game is in open protocol, not in closed loop system. Many apps, including the app of my own bank, are now getting stored value account agnostic, which means you don't need to be, in my example, a Bank Alpha customer to use my Alpha app. You can be any bank's customers and attach your stored value account and use the features that my app has to offer. And I know other banks are deploying the similar strategies. So yes, I acknowledge that you have said. I don't want to go into the pricing while I have a view on ATM versus online, but I think industry as a whole has not done enough. Just once, I think this gentleman at the back was raised his hand for far too long. I agree. मैं अभी क्वेश्चन लेता हूँ और इसी प्राइसिंग, आई थिंक अ बिगर किलर एंड आई वॉन्ट टू लिंक दिस। सो एक तो ये कि आई फुली एग्री, आई थिंक स्विच चार्जेस आर नॉट दैट मच एज वॉट द बैंक्स हैव डिसाइडेड शुड बी द मार्केट प्राइस फॉर IBFT, एंड इट डजेंट मेक सेंस। आई एग्री विद यू के ATM प्राइसिंग वर्सेज ऑनलाइन IBFT प्राइसिंग बट आई थिंक द बिगर किलर देन दिस इज वॉट आई रेफर्ड इन माई टॉक on the merchant discount rates. I think jab tak hum sab, we've all been there, aap koi cheez lene ke liye jaye, petrol dalwane jaye, kahin aur jane chahe, wo kahe sir ya machine kharab hai, wo pehli shakal dekhega mere, ye MDR de sakta hai ya nahi de sakta, agar wo kahega de sakta hai kahega sir 2% upar lagega extra, meri shakal se lagega, nahi de sakta kahega sir machine kharab hai. I think that's the bigger killer working against the digitization of the whole payment ecosystem than anything else. 50 billion dollars ki cash economy hai hamare mulk ki, 50 billion. 70 saalon mein humne 35,000 POS devices lagayi hain is mulk mein, myself included, doob ke mar jana chahiye hame. 2 million merchants hain is mulk mein, 2 million merchants, Nielsen ne documented kahi hai report mein, 2 million merchants hain, usme sirf 35,000 ke upar proudly humne 70 saalon mein wo ek machine lagayi hai jiske upar hum aur aap jaake debit ya credit card transactions karte hain. So the bigger killer working against that is the MDR piece. Or usme bhi just a little bit of glimpse out of that is because we got it absolutely wrong. Humne kya kiya, humne ek group apna banaya, financial institutes ki baat kar raha hu, ek group banaya jinka kaam ye tha machine lagana aur MDR ko maximize karna. Unka KPI yahi tha bicharon ka. Ek group tha, unka KPI tha, अच्छा जब ये लग जाए तो देख लेना, दिल चाहे तो मर्चेंट फाइनेंसिंग कर देना इस मर्चेंट की. वो एहसान करते थे अगर मर्चेंट फाइनेंसिंग कर लेते थे, विच इज़ द एसएमई गाइस. एंड द थर्ड ग्रुप दैट वी हैड वाज द ब्रांचेस, जिसके अंदर वो अकाउंट होता था जिसमें सारा फ्लोट आता था. सो ब्रांचेस वर सिटिंग प्रिटी, दे वर अर्निंग ऑल द फ्लोट इनकम एंड पब्लिशिंग एंड रिकॉर्डिंग द फ्लोट इनकम. एमडीआर वाला बेचारा एमडीआर बढ़ा बढ़ा के पागल हो गया एंड मर्चेंट एमडीआर दे दे के पागल हो गया. और जो मर्चेंट फाइनेंस वाला था उसका दिल चाह तो उसने भी रेवेन्यू बुक कर लिया और अपनी बुक में बुक कर लिया एंड ही इज़ हैप्पी, ऑल्दो ही टुक नो रिस्क व्हाटसोएवर बिकॉज द इनकमिंग पेमेंट्स वर ऑलरेडी कमिंग टू द मर्चेंट अकाउंट. सो इफ एनी वन हु शुड हैव बीन गिवन द क्रेडिट फॉर ऑल ऑफ दिस वर दोज कार्ड स्कीम पीपल, द कंज्यूमर फाइनेंस गाइज जिसको हम कहते हैं, हु शुड हैव बीन एबल टू लुक एट. सो इट्स unfortunately there are a lot more inefficiencies that exist in the system. Janab, sorry, you were first. Ji, एक्सीलेंट, लोडेड क्वेश्चन. अब दो तीन सवाल दाग दिए हैं साथ ही साथ. जो कैश ऑन डिलीवरी आपका पहला सवाल ये था विज वी द रेस्ट ऑफ द मार्केट्स, देखें ऑल मार्केट्स हैव मोस्टली स्टार्टेड ऑफ विद कैश ऑन डिलीवरी, बट एज आई सेड बिफोर पेटीएम्स या अली बाबाज ऑफ दिस वर्ल्ड हैड एन ऑब्सेशन विद वॉलेट्स, डिजिटल पेमेंट अकाउंट्स, बिकॉज दे वॉन्टेड टू टेक दिस 2-3% कॉस्ट आउट ऑफ. उनके लिए तो फ्रैक्शन ऑफ अ बेसिस पॉइंट इज इंपॉर्टेंट, तो 300 बेसिस पॉइंट तो बहुत बड़ी कॉस्ट है उनके लिए. सो दे हैव स्टार्टेड टू मूव नाउ. सो आई थिंक देयर प्रोपोर्शन इज अ लॉट मोर फेवरेबल टू डिजिटल पेमेंट्स देन इट इज टू अदर्स. योर नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन वॉज कि जी वॉट वी कैन डू टूगेदर. मैंने जैसे पहले कहा कि आई थिंक प्लेयर्स सच एज फाइनेंशियल सर्विसेज इंस्टीट्यूट्स हैव दिस रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी of looking at the value chain of e-commerce and logistics as one, and then start to move away from the merchant discount rates, start to embrace the consumer and merchant financing, and start to recognize the float income. And then if you really wish to know your customers, launch your own marketplace. You would get to know your customers, but don't make per product margin. Wo hamara game nahi hai, wo e-commerce merchant ka game hai. आपका आखिरी सवाल ये था कि क्या करें स्टार्टअप्स. Yeah. So I'm going to answer. I got it. So, usme most financial institutes, including my own bank, have an incubation program, which we work with certain fintechs and startups, on whom or both organizations, the fintech and the bank, are willing to take a bet on each other, and then we incubate their idea. We open our APIs, we give them access to our number of customers, we give them access to the marketing dollars that we have, and they also have to take a bet on us, right, whether we are the right institute or not. I think the biggest mistake we can do as a big organization is to get someone really cheap. That's the biggest mistake we do. So, and I think it's heartening to see most bigger organizations. I was looking at my previous organization, this Velocity, when we all started, when I was still in Telenor. Most big organizations are now more equitable than they were before in inviting. In fact, some organizations don't even ask for any equity into a fintech or a startup anymore. Some do. And they say, "Theek hai, come to us, we like your idea, aap isko white label kar le, ek saal ki exclusivity sign kar le, ek saal tak sirf mere customers ko hum isko pitch karenge." There are lots of ways to skin a cat. So aap got answered. So, two questions. Pehle ka to ye ki use facilities such as these, the National Incubation Centers, which are now the hub of connecting industry with fintechs and startups. So, I think we must use these facilities, and it's as much incumbent upon me as industry as it is incumbent upon yourself as a fintech and a startup to continue to use this as a connecting hub. So, this is that dating website where we should all meet. जो आपका क्वेश्चन था कि हाउ बैंक्स और अदर ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस परसीव फिनटेक्स एंड स्टार्टअप, यस आई थिंक देयर वाज अ टाइम अ व्हाइल अगो दो वेयर दे सॉ इट एज अ कंपटीशन. आई थिंक नाउ दे सी इट मोर एज अ कोलैबोरेशन बिकॉज वी बोथ हैव समथिंग टू ऑफर टू ईच अदर विच नन ऑफ अस हैज इंडिविजुअली. वी डू नॉट हैव द निम्बलनेस. वी मे हैव द ब्रेन पावर, वी डोंट हैव द निम्बलनेस ऑफ एक्सप्लोरिंग द न्यू आइडियाज as quickly as we would have liked to. And we don't have all the time in the world to try and create all of those ideas. You guys do. What you don't have the expertise to scaling up an idea. First, the expertise. Marketing dollars to baad mein aate hain. You know, with all the humbleness, if I take myself back 23 years ago, I didn't know where to start, right? How to set up a company, how to do market, which information to look for. So that's what the bigger organizations offer. So I think now I've started to see them work. All of these velocities and the incubation programs are testimony to that they now see more as a partnership. Janab, sorry, yes. Mm-hmm. It's a good question, and I think it's a relative moot point. I don't think many people have spoken or talked about it, but I do understand the cross-border transactions have certainly issues in it. Dekhen, iska ek to ye ki the central bank is also trying to do a lot of stuff in promoting the international remittances coming in, and they are mandating banks to do certain things. For example, one of those things is that every account should have an IBAN number. If you have an IBAN number, it's relatively easy for the money to land into the destination. I honestly do not feel that enough has been said or worked upon on this particular issue, but the solution exists. The solution is, if you have a normal account in a bank here, if the clearing bank is the right bank, if the IBAN number is the right number, then there is no reason why the money should not land, given all the incentivization central bank gives for the incoming remittances there. But I also acknowledge that there are issues when the cross-border transactions happen.
Why PayPal cannot PayPal
doesn't want to come to Pakistan for various reasons. One of them is, I know it's an easier way, but you know, they can, international organizations, unless they're Chinese, they have issues, unfortunately, for coming to countries such as ours. Very unfortunate, but that's how they think. Why do you think international banks shut down from Pakistan? They were making good money. So, but it is what it is. Good luck to them. If they don't want to come, we have enough, inshallah, brain power of our own. We'll create it. Janab. Yeah, I'm smiling because there's somebody sitting here who spent his life doing it. So I'm sure I would not be able to do justice to how he could have answered this. But I think the internet payment gateways have been working constantly to try and reduce this rejection rate. And it happens for a multitude of reasons. It happens if the merchant information is eroded. It happens when the customer does not have enough funds in the account, which is very relatively common. It happens when the issuing bank has limited the number of merchants on which the card can be used. It happens when the issuing bank does not want their card to be used on internet. It's the multitude of those reasons. Uski white listing hoti hai, PAN numbers ki, merchants ki. So, but the unfortunately consumer doesn't know all this and doesn't care about all this. All the sees is media transactions reject over. So good, conscientious internet payment gateway providers or acquirers are constantly working to try and minimize this rejection rate, but we are nowhere near the international standards. I agree. Chiram.
I think we also need to see the beyond the problem as feasible. I think one thing will affect what we want is digital banking. Today, banks are automating their self-checkout mobile. Of course, Bangalore Plus application is not digital banking. Digital banking has its own. So the way things are moving, why do I need a bank to keep my money? Because of the word McKenzie said, the future of the bank, there was no bank institution. So that's where I see more, I think there will be more ideas and bigger game that is system for because that digital banking licensing on the state bank. Again, the second question to us is, how are regulators seeing this emerging market? Because today, if you look at the MFS, to be regulated by the bank. We have to have a bank that actually they don't need it. Our regulators are sort of facilitating this new ideas and new ways where we can have them what we call alert.
Great. For the first question, how much time have you got?
Session for them. I think that's what an idea.
But I'll very briefly just touch upon it. They can, we need to distinguish between automation and digitization. Right? The automation is brushing up lubrication of the existing systems, right? And do something that you used to take 21 days, do it in one day. Great automation, right? But you are still. You have not changed the user experience of doing something digitally. You're still asking the customer to come in my branch, I'm giving an example, to apply for a credit card or a debit card or a checkbook. Right? If it used to take me 7 days to open an account in branch, through automation I can open it in one day, great. Well, life is good. But the digitization of that is I have an app-only bank, which is a digital bank, I don't have any branch, I can open an account remotely, I can issue a virtual debit card, I can issue a virtual credit card using digital credit scorecard, and the instant gratification with a complete different user experience is what the digitization is. Big banks, you'll be surprised, big banks, the likes of Wells Fargo's, the likes of Santander's, even the likes of Citi's, they do automation. Because they've already got there. They don't have anyone else to beat. They think, you know what? Why change something when it's not broken? I am going to do automation. And if I used to take 3 days to open an account, I'm going to do it in one day. Great, I have no one else to beat because I'm so big. I have that weight advantage. Mid-tier banks, smaller banks, have no future if they don't do digitization. Digitization is not about cost cutting either. It's about user experience and through user experience, customer acquisition. Why did Easy Paisa ended up having 22 million customers when all banks in this country put together has 30 million customers in a space of 6-7 years. So absolutely the right observation that you have shared, and I unfortunately feel very passionate about the distinction between automation and digitization. Your second question was the thought process of regulator. I think they're very, very pro digitization, and I can speak with experience, having worked with them for a number of years. They are very, very pro. Despite all the constraints we have in Pakistan for anti-money laundering and terrorist financing, unfortunately, yet they are so pro. There was a time when we were under so much pressure, and it was actually part of your national financial inclusion strategy and anti-terrorist financing strategy to actually shut down OTC money transfers. But the regulator worked together with the industry to try and find a solution, which is a biometric-based solution. So they are relatively pro. It takes them time to move to a new idea. Like cryptocurrencies is still like a conversation from Mars, but gradually they'll come around to it. They announced to the public. It's no hidden that they have engaged Karandas recently to advise them about the minimum capital requirement for launching a digital bank. So Karandas is working. I think I'm expecting that, by the end of the year or first quarter next year, they would be in a position.
That's a great initiative you can give a talk to a startup. Mm. And that's where the integration of the social very scoring
to yeah, they can. But startups don't have to wait for a state bank to issue a digital banking license.
Start now. I'm just asking you to just wait time and give that kind of perspective.
Yeah.
We'll definitely have that.
Inshallah, we'll do. Last two we'll take, if that's okay. Jinaab.
क्यों कर रहे थे, आप गलती से सर अकाउंट बनाया ना सोचता हूँ, और दो दिन तक मैंने मोबाइल साइलेंट रहे, इतनी मतलब एक दिन में कंप्लेन की और उसके बाद ज्यादा कॉल कर लाइक दिस इज द एक्सपीरियंस अबाउट डेटा तो उनकी मैच्योरिटी की है मार्केट में मेरी भी
पहले तो अल्लाह का लाख लाख शुक्र है मैंने इजी पैसा छोड़ दिया बट आई एम फेमिलियर विद दिस प्रॉब्लम. मेरा असल में मेरे जो हेड ऑफ इंश्योरेंस था ना वो ओवर जेलस हेड ऑफ इंश्योरेंस था, वो छोड़ता नहीं था किसी को वो डेटा निकाल के. बट इट्स रॉन्ग, इट्स इनकरेक्ट, इट हैड टू बी स्टॉप्ड. आई स्टॉप्ड the but your broader question on the use of data is the right one. I think the silver lining in the Facebook fiasco was for the general public to be aware of their own rights. We were not even aware of our own rights. Ab at least general public ye kehti hai ki agar mujhse consent nahi liya gaya to tum mere data ko use nahi karo. Ha, if you take consent from me कि मैं तुम्हें क्रेडिट देना चाहता हूँ, तुम लेना चाहते हो, हाँ मैं लेना चाहता हूँ, इन ऑर्डर फॉर यू टू अवेल क्रेडिट आई एम गोइंग टू यूज योर सोशल मीडिया डेटा, योर इनबॉक्स डेटा, योर ऑल ऑफ दैट डेटा, डू यू अलाउ? एंड इफ यू से आई अलाउ देन वी प्रोसीड फॉरवर्ड, अदरवाइज वी डोंट. आई डोंट थिंक दिस रियलाइजेशन वॉज देयर बिफोर दिस फेसबुक थिंग. तो अब जो रिस्पॉन्सिबल एप्स हैं दे आस्क फॉर इट, इरिस्पॉन्सिबल की मैं आई कैन नॉट स्पीक फॉर. लास्ट क्वेश्चन सो आई सी द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ ब्लॉकचेन इन लार्ज स्केल पब्लिक फंडेड प्रोजेक्ट फाइनेंसिंग. I see that. What is blockchain? Blockchain is the authentication of a certain transaction within the algorithm that has been created that no one else can bypass and come into that blockchain. And if, in fact, ये जो अभी हमारा नया initiative है जिसके ऊपर हम पैसे जमा करें dams के लिए, this would have been a classic example of actually using blockchain technology. So that disintermediation happens, so that no other unknown player can come in the ecosystem. Right? But anyway, we are not there yet. My belief is blockchain would come. Maybe we are not there yet. Time is not right. We have lots of other problems to solve right now. Right. Thank you very much for listening. I'm humbled. Thank you.
थैंक यू वेरी मच. आप सब लोगों का बहुत शुक्रिया आप लोग आए. एक छोटी सी चीज़ में वहाँ खड़ा हुआ था, सोच रहा था, मैंने 1.5 साल एक प्रोजेक्ट पे काम किया है जिसमें इनकी टीम के साथ हम लोग काम कर रहे थे, और मुझे 1.5 साल में मिला के इतना टाइम नहीं मिला जितना आज इनको सुनने का मिला. मैं आप सब लोगों का बहुत शुक्र गुजार हूँ आप लोग आए, और बाहर तैयार है चाय, प्लीज़ आएँ, और चाय के दौरान भी आप अपने क्वेश्चंस रखें. और थैंक यू वेरी मच. थैंक यू सर. थैंक यू. बहुत शुक्रिया आपका. प्लीज़.